ஹே ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ், ஹாய், ஹலோ, வணக்கம். டி டுடே இன்டர்வியூ சீரீஸ் மூலயமா நீங்கள் ஏகப்பட்ட சிவில் சர்வன்ஸோடைய இன்ஸ்பைரிங்கான இன்டர்வியூஸ் எல்லாத்தையும் பார்த்துட்டு இருக்கீங்கல்ல. அந்த வகையில் இந்த வீக் நம்ம பார்க்க போகிறது ரிஷப் ஐஏஎஸ் அவர்களுடைய இன்டர்வியூ தான். ஸோ கன்னியாகுமரி அசிஸ்டன்ட் கலெக்டராக இருக்கக்கூடிய அவரோட டைமை ஸ்பெண்ட் பண்ணி நமக்கு ஏகப்பட்ட இன்புட்ஸ் கொடுத்துருக்காங்க. அண்ட் இந்த பர்டிகுலர் வீடியோவில் ரொம்ப முக்கியமாக அவரோட பர்சனல் ஜேர்னி மட்டும் இல்லாமல், நம்ம ஒரு புது ஆஸ்பிரண்ட்டாக இருக்கோம் இல்லை பிகினராக ஒருத்தவங்க இந்த ஜேர்னியை ஸ்டார்ட் பண்ணுறாங்க அப்படின்னா, அவங்க என்னென்ன விதமான செல்ஃப் அனாலிசிஸ்லாம் பண்ணணும் அண்ட் என்னென்ன விஷயங்களை கான்சென்ட்ரேட் பண்ணணும், இந்த மாதிரியான ஏகப்பட்ட விஷயங்கள் இந்த பர்டிகுலர் வீடியோவில் இருக்கு. ஸோ உங்களோட பிகினர் ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ் எல்லாருக்குமே இதை ஷேர் பண்ணீங்க, டெஃபினட்டா எல்லாருக்கும் யூஸ்ஃபுல்லா இருக்கும் அப்படின்னு நான் நம்புறேன். அண்ட் ஓவர் டு தி வீடியோ.
யூ ஹேவ் கிரியேட்டட் அ ரியல் குட் பிளாட்ஃபார்ம் ஃபார் மெனி ஆஃப் அஸ் டு இன்ஸ்பயர் ஃபார் கெட்டிங் இன்டு யுபிஎஸ்சி அண்ட் ஸ்டார்டிங் அ ப்ரிபரேஷன். சோ வேர் டிட் யுவர் தாட் ஆஃப் கெட்டிங் இன்டு யுபிஎஸ்சி ஸ்டார்ட் அண்ட் இந்த ப்ரிபரேஷன் மொத்தமா எப்படி நடக்கும்?
My thought started in the last year of college, final year. I wanted to do something, so I thought UPSC was optional. Then I was not very sure about pursuing UPSC. That time UPSC was just an option. I got into Infosys. So getting into Infosys was my, you know, it was like I got a job. By April I graduated and in May I was to join Infosys at Mastery. So actually I joined in 2014 at Infosys. While I was working in the Infosys, I felt that I had much more potential. I could do much more to things. In my Infosys, I found that I was not doing anything which directly impacts someone. It was like, you know, I haven't met my manager, my senior manager, everyone were abroad. And I don't know what I was doing. And I kind of felt that my work is very mechanistic. And I had a lot of potential and I could do much bigger things. So it just, I had to dream a lot. So I resigned my job and I started preparing for UPSC. And that's how my journey started. I started in 2015, somewhere in the month of August, I started my preparation. And by 2019, I cleared this examination. So it was somewhere around 3 years and 10 months of my journey, 3 years or 8 months, over closer to 4 years of my journey.
When we start, நமக்கு வந்துட்டு நிறைய விஷயங்கள் நம்ம யோசிப்போம், whether to leave our job or things. And we also have a thought of how I could sustain and அந்த மாதிரியான SWOT analysis definitely நம்ம எல்லாரும் பண்ணணும். So புதுசா வரக்கூடிய aspirants UPSC படிக்கணும் அப்படின்னு வரும்போது what kind of SWOT analysis they should do and how can they take that thing of either coming from directly to college or should work and come. So அதை அவங்க எப்படி எடுக்கலாம் நீங்க சஜஸ்ட் பண்ணுங்க.
It really depends. See, for me, I worked for a year because and the one varsha work panumbodhu enak therinjidhu that this is not the field I wanted to be. Information technology was not the field I wanted to be, and you know, I cannot sit here and tell that I don't want to be in this IT field unless I go on over there and I experience. I wanted to give a shot at how the corporate world feels, and personally I was not very enriched and satisfied with the experience that I got over there. So that is something. Second, UPSC journey, it takes a lot of economic nare selav panna vendidhu irukku, right? From your coaching fees la irundhu, your home rent, house rent la irundhu, your food, you need to spend a lot of money. So that 1 year I could save some money, so I could save some 1.5 lakhs, so adhu vechi I paid my fee, and for next 1.5 years I could sustain. Third vandu namba idhu dhaan pannuvoma, because see, once you are getting into it, coming out, then it will become 4-5 years, and when you are coming out, either you are becoming an officer or you are nothing. It's that simple. It's very binary. Either you are an officer or you are nothing. Okay, if you are 4 years you are spending in one field, and when you cannot go back to IT field. Suppose I could spend 4 years in preparation for UPSC. If I am going back to IT field, I may not be feeling very comfortable over there, because my friends in that IT field, they have gone to the technological lead, TL, TL is the position where after 5-6 years you reach. So they have become, they could have got promoted to a TL level, and I was going and starting again as a fresher only, because last 4 years I haven't worked anywhere. So I have forgotten everything about IT. Anywhere where I'm going, I have to be joining as a fresher. Correct. So this creates an immense burden on you, and no one wants to give a job to a person who has graduated in 2014, in 2018 or 19. So there are a lot of things one person has to see. See, first thing is whether the person really wants to do UPSC. Okay, he really wants to sit and prepare and put some 3-4 years of his life in this. It's a very hard decision. And someone cannot take that decision just because their father and mother said it. Or probably some of their grandfather has said it. Or, you know, Chinna Isla, they would have seen some IS officer, they would have seen some collector. Even I want to be a collector or movie path. I have seen people who have seen movies and they have come and said, I want to be IPS. He asked, why you want to become IPS? Because now the movie path, Singham Pada path, I want to change the system. That's why I want to come and become an IPS. So, see, that is not at all practical. Okay, what shown in movies completely different from what's there. I know how IPS officers toil and their life is nothing that is shown in movies. Not even 1% shown in movies is closer to a life of an IPS officer. So things are very different. So first of all, on the field, if they want to prepare for UPC, they have to be very sure. I mean, they want to do this or not. Because if they are well off, kind of financially well off, if they have a backup option, then it is well and good. Second, they have to tell to their parents that it will take 3 to 4 years. They have to get a time. Parents in an clear it. When I cleared prelims in my first term, my mom thought that I cleared the entire examination, I'm going to become an IAS. Okay, so I had to convince her that this is not the process. It takes even interview fail on alu, you have to come back from the prelims. So it's a very long process. So convince your parents that what you're doing, they have to, you know, support you. Your parents are the biggest supporter. So that analysis you have to do. And then how you're going to prepare. Whether you are going to a coaching institute or you are going to do a self-study. So how you are going to prepare, you have to see that analysis. Suppose 2 years down the line, you run out of money, what are you going to do? You have to see that. What is your backup option? You should keep a backup option. You should keep that 3 attempts I will give or 2 attempts I will give. I am not going to give any attempts. You should have a backup option. You should see that if not for this exam, what exam can I write? I used to write a lot of exams. Not only UPSC, I got selected to the CAP of Central Armed Police Forces, Assistant Commandant, and the exam. I got an interview call, but since I got into UPSC CSA, I didn't attend that interview. Probably I will be the first person to get an interview call and still did not go and attend the interview at the UPSC. When UPSC gives you an interview call, you don't attend an interview call. How many people you have met like that? So I got an opportunity, I got it IAS, so I didn't attend that interview of CAPF. But still, after my interview, I had the physical examination for that, where we used to do a running. They were running long jump. There were certain exercises rather for a physical examination. So I went for that physical also. So that was my backup. I had 2-3 backups. So that was one of my backup. I was into teaching. So in my free time, after my second attempt, I used to take certain classes, paper correction. I was doing something like that. So that was one of the backup options which I created for myself. UPSC CAP exam was one backup option which I created for myself. In my first attempt, I attempted CDS examination, Combined Defense Services, and I got a call for SSB. So that was another backup option for myself. So I created 2-3 backup options so that if not civil services, then at least one of these backup options I could check. Because I have seen people who are only there, like I want to only do UPSC civil services, and they forget that, you know, you need to have a backup because tomorrow you are not clearing after 4th attempt, you are still nothing. Okay, you need some backup option. So this is the analysis which one has to do before probably joining this journey, I feel.
Thank you, sir. As you rightly said, so namaste in the exam clear pandra and the point. So even before that minute, and the minute munadi kuda, we will be somewhere jobless or we will be aspiring people, and after that minute everything changes. பட் இங்க வந்துட்டு எல்லாருக்குமே நம்ம ஜெயிச்சதுக்கு அப்புறம் உள்ள விஷயங்கள் தட்ஸ் கம்ப்ளீட்லி டிஃபரண்ட் பட் ஃபார் ஆஸ்பிரன்ட்ஸ் அந்த அவங்க ஜெயிக்கிற அந்த பாயிண்ட் வரைக்கும் when they are taking it, they have to face multiple people, they have to face the society, relatives, again parents and multiple people. So how to maintain that? So okay, I can do it, having a self confidence இல்ல at times நமக்கு self doubt வர ஆரம்பிக்கும். So how to maintain this and how to proceed?
Okay, so what I did was, I joined a hostel where people used to prepare for civil services examination. So people around me, they were very serious people. So first of all is that have your friends who are very serious. You can go to coaching institute that you can find few people who are as serious as you. So first is your friend circle should be very serious. So that when they don't divert yourself from the they don't divert you. Second, speak openly with your parents that what is your status? How are you performing? That is very important because unga parents unga mela hope lose panna aarambichitaanga na then you need not prove yourself to anyone else other than your parents. Okay, so your family members are your supporting pillars. So avanga kitta nalla pesi vechikonga. You have one have to be very frank with them. If you are not preparing well, you have to tell your parents that this is where I am lagging or this is something I am finding difficulty with. Third thing, be true to yourself. At the end of the day, you have taken a very conscious decision that you have started preparation for UPSC and you have to leave no stone unturned. For na enna panna na vandu I started in 2015 la, so that time I had an app in my mobile phone which used to track that how much time I am spending on social media websites. Facebook la how much time I am spending, Twitter la how much time I am spending. That time Snapchat was very famous, Instagram. So I was checking that in the Aurora app la how much time I was spending. I found that per day 1.5 hours and 2 hours I'm spending unwantedly in social media. So I uninstalled all the social media. So you could see my Facebook account I last opened somewhere in 2016, I think. It's been 4 years, I haven't opened my Facebook account. So I kind of distanced myself from each of the social media things. And I didn't go to any family functions. I didn't go to any movies. I did this at a huge personal cost. A huge sacrifice. I am here because I have sacrificed a lot. It's not that I just went and wrote my examination. So once I couldn't get a good guidance in Chennai, or I felt that I need something more, I had to go to Delhi. So I was ready for that also. So 2 years I was in Delhi. I was ready to go to Delhi and I was ready to prepare from there. So I was ready to do as much as I can. So I never limited that I can. I have to do only this. I have to do only this. So I was okay because for me, my only at the point of time, my aim was to clear this examination. To clear this examination, I can go to any extent I want. Then I did travel a lot of extent, which not many would do. So I am here because I did that much of sacrifices. So that's what a person should do probably.
So that's the end of part 1 of the video of this interview series with Mr. Rishabh IAS. So in the interview, உங்களுக்கு பயங்க யூஸ்ஃபுல்லாக இருந்திருக்கும். ரொம்ப முக்கியமாக பிகினர்ஸ்க்கு நிறைய இன்சைட்ஸ் கிடைச்சிருக்கும் அப்படின்னு நான் நினைக்கிறேன். வாட்ஸ் எவர் ப்ளீஸ் டூ சேவ் இந்த காமெண்ட்ஸ் பிலோ. அண்ட் இன்னும் நிறைய விஷயங்களை நம்ம அவர் கூட பேசியிருக்கோம். அண்ட் அது எல்லாம் அடுத்தடுத்த பார்ட்ஸில் உங்களுக்கு வரப்போகுது. ஸோ ஸ்டே டியூன்ட். அண்ட் இஃப் யூ பீப்புள் வாண்ட் டு ஃபாலோ மீ ஆர் ஹிம் பர்சனலி, எங்களுடைய சோஷியல் மீடியா லிங்க்ஸை கீழே டிஸ்கிரிப்ஷனில் கொடுத்துருக்கேன். யூ கேன் ஃபாலோ அஸ் தே. தேங்க்ஸ் அலாட் ஃபார் ஆல் யூர் சப்போர்ட். தேங்க்யூ.